fact, to use the words of a former friend of mine once said, who I have great respect for, I am a simple woodsman, and I rise to support this budget and thus vote override the veto. See, as a forester, I'm taught to look to the future. In fact, I used to say when I was working in the woods that someday my grandchildren, if they ever have Allison, used to say, Dad had this right when he went in the woods. He did the right thing. Look at the forest that's flourishing. Or, whoops, he missed this one. And maybe he should have done something differently. But oftentimes, we thought in terms of 30 years, 40 years, so sometimes as short as 3 years to see whether we're successful. So I'm actually going to look at this budget in the same way. But first, I do need to say this. I'm so impressed with the committee's work. I oftentimes go to schools and talk to them about our committee process, that we have D's and R's and I's, senators and House representatives on that committee, and they work together. That's what's so different about us and other state governments and the federal government. So I publicly thank you for the work that you did at your Congress. Now back to forestry and the budget. I decided to use a tree. We're talking about the roots of the budget, which is the income tax proposal that we passed 3 years ago. That's still intact. We must not forget that. And what's more important to me is that farms and small businesses are protected. Now we turn to the trunk of the tree, it's the education. It's funded. And yes, I do believe retirement should be included in the school system's budget. But you need to give them time to adjust to that. This budget did that. I think of the branches. In that case, I think of revenue sharing. As a town selectman, I now work to manage our budget. I go to all my town meetings as best I can to see how hard they do. And unlike Senator Cleveland, I was not here during the shutdown, but I was here during the original LD1, when we put parameters on what a municipality could increase their taxes by. It was based on a percent of growth and inflation, without getting into the intricacies of the formula. Recent reports said 75% of the towns are living under those calculations. Now, I would bet if you took time to look at the other 25%, you'd find out that maybe a third of that, if not more, had an extraordinary situation. Fire truck, building burned down, or something like that. So our communities are working very hard to live under that. Now, I don't disagree that someday that should be reduced. But one of the key things we came out of this with is we're going to look at the town mandates. What have we told the towns to do that we don't need to do? And maybe that's what revenue sharing went to tap those mandates, whether it's the salt shed, whether it's the doctor, whether it's closing the landfill. Those are things that we told communities they have to do, this revenue sharing helps them. Second part that I look at believes is the fact we talked about taxing the nonprofits. And we've gone in there and we're looking at what that can do for us, because that may provide an opportunity, but the time wasn't there. So we decided to address that. We protected the seniors, drugs for the elderly, circuit breaker. We've actually put that in a form now that people can take advantage of it, rather than have to acquire something completely separate and different. And we've actually fully funded the homestead exemption, which was one of my big objections under the old days of money. So yes, like a tree, we need some fertilizer. And yes, there's a sales tax. I admit that. It's a revenue increase. However, the good news is sunset. That's our opportunity, those of us that are here in 2 years, to change that if we want to. And I like to think of it as a chance for the leaves that are on the tree that I've just described, fall to the crown, and naturally fertilize the tree. So as a forester, thinking about this in the long term, I think we set this up, stay up, to prosper. I disagree with some of my colleagues, which we all do. And I think as a forester, Maine will do better. So today, I go green with my good friend and fellow blogger, Troy Jackson.
Chair,